Look at the Asian markets in trade. It's a week-old start to the trading week, and investors again battling more news flow out of the Chinese market. This time, new bank loans tumbling in the month of July. And as we talk about a tumble, down 89% from the prior month. So big reset here. Also on key credit gauges weakening. So investors again looking at the money supply and effectively seeing some weakness here. The M2 in July plus 10.7% versus a forecast of 11%. But again, the strains are there despite all the loosening from the authorities, from the PBOC on rates, still not stimulating fresh demand for credit here. And you can see the Chinese stock market modestly downbeat. Most of the falls really dominating the Hong Kong market, though 400 points in the red, more than 2% weaker as we kick off the trading week. You can see that Japanese and Australian stocks also impacted by the latest news flow. The handover from Wall Street, of course, somewhat mixed, and that's not helping out sentiment as we get going today. Let's take a look at WTI and Brent. Still a lot of geopolitics as investors are closely watching Russia at this point, but it is downbeat action today, and perhaps it is that story around the economy that we are seeing impact WTI and Brent more, down more than 1%, 82.18 on WTI this morning, 85.80, the handle on Brent. You can see European futures this morning as we gear up for trade, also in the red. So certainly the colour of the day today, the FTSE futures picture and the French market only modestly down versus the signal we're getting on the DAX. 9/10, so close to 1% expected to come off that market. Italian stocks in the mix are about a third of a percent weaker. But as we closed out the trading week, it was very downbeat and these markets played catch up to the US action. They'd been outperforming before we got to Friday. We dropped about 1% plus on the bench. Mark, so that flipped a lot of the boards negative for the trading week versus positive. It was only really French stocks still holding out in positive territory as we closed out the trading week. To US futures, as we European stock markets are open for trade, and the early signals have been red this morning. We are chasing a lot of negativity. We're seeing it across the Asian markets today. Again, more weak news coming through from the mainland market, this time on new loans for the month of July, effectively falling 89% from the prior. Real estate technology down roughly 0.2%. Foxconn numbers, the big one to seize upon this morning, telling us a weakening demand story right across from the consumer and devices through to what the business side has been doing on investing in cloud of late. In terms of financials, we're down by about 0.1%. Industrials down by less than 0.1%. Utilities, a slight slippage. From there, we're pushing positive. We've got chemicals, media stocks trying to stage a rally. Retail names, M&S the top performer, and that is a decent bounce, 2.7% in that stock. Telcos are trading higher, Telefonica one of the better ones. In terms of healthcare, up by about 0.25% there, and food and drink also getting an early nudge higher. It is in fact some of those drink names and food names from Danone to Diageo that are higher at this stage. Let's take a look at the starting point on these boards, 7516. We haven't moved very far on the FTSE. We've added about 0.1% versus a drop of about 1.25% in that Friday trade. So we're really not picking up any of that territory at this stage. And the French market, similar tune, 7334. It is slightly weaker at this stage, flatlining the DAX as it opens up for trade. Elsewhere, the IBEX is down by about 0.1%. We've dropped 0.2% on the Italian market. Of course, the big story last week was really around those banks and the windfall tax that was lobbed. The SMI trades are flat, even though with a patch of green at this point. So it is a choppy old start to this market. Let's get into China. The Chinese property giant Country Garden suspended trading in several of its onshore bonds after saying Friday that it will restructure its debt after missing payments on two bond coupons. Meanwhile, new bank loans in China dropped to the lowest level since 2009 last month, despite policymakers cutting interest rates and committing to more support for the flagging economy. Across the board, you can see the extent of the declines, particularly felt on the Hong Kong market because of those property stocks. So you can see down 2% for the Hang Seng at this stage. Let's peel away from those boards and take a look at what we've got on the Hong Kong mainland property market, 3.7%, as you can see, for those stocks, accounting for the outsized falls, and for tech down more than 2% at this stage. To WTI and Brent, early on, we've seen a drop here, 1.2 down on Brent, WTI down 1.3. So it is a pullback there, and that is impacting those oil stocks. You saw it initially on the open, but here, a direct look at those big plays, roughly 0.8 down on BP, almost 0.7 off Shell, and TotalEnergies. Let's get to Credit Suisse and UBS. Credit Suisse retail investors are reportedly planning to sue UBS, challenging the buyout. According to multiple media reports, a group representing more than 1,000 individual investors, including former employees, they're planning to file a lawsuit in Zurich as soon as today. They claim to have lost money in the takeover, accusing both banks of horse trading. You can see UBS stock close to the flat line today, a slight patch of green now, about a tenth of a percent higher. Let's get to Phillips. The move here strong, 5.9%. We've seen it straight out of the gates this morning rallying. This as it's announced that the Dutch investment firm Exor has taken a 15% stake in the company, intending to be a long-term shareholder. The healthcare technology stated that while the stake was purchased on the open market, the firms had agreed on a price in advance. Let's get to Bilfinger, which posted a 6% rise in second quarter revenue. The stock is moving strongly, this with growth margins jumping to over 10%. Now, the German industrial services group said it saw growing demand for its energy transition solutions, now up 7%, and year-to-date, the stock is up 22%. Speaking to CNBC this morning, the CEO, Thomas Schulz, said the future presented a mixed picture.